Hello students, good morning. Today we will study theater of absurd. This term theater of absurd was first coined by critic Martin Esslin when he was evaluating his drama of Harold Pinter. Then he coined this term the theater of the absurd. It is a new style of drama that seemed to ignore theatrical convention and part audience expectation. What is the meaning of theatrical convention? Theatrical convention, what we expect from a drama, what an audience expect from a comedy or tragedy, it what that expectations and have something new. Such kind of plays are called theater of absurd, plays of absurd. This theater of absurd is characterized by a departure from realistic character and situation. The play offers no clear notion of the time or place in which the actions occur. Characters are often nameless in such kind of plays, and they seem interchangeable also. Events are completely outside of the outside the realm of rational motivation and may have a nightmarish quality, commonly associated with surrealism. What was surrealism? A post World War First movement that features dream sequences and images from the unconscious, often sexual in nature. At the other time, both dialogue and incidents may appear to the audience as completely nonsensical, even farcical. However, beneath the surface, the works explore themes of loneliness and isolation, of the failure of individuals to connect with others in any meaningful way, and of the senselessness and absurdity of life and death. What are the major themes of theaters of absurd? First is absurdity. Absurdity is the most obvious theme explored in the absurdism. It is explained by its name. Absurdity characterizes a world that no longer makes sense to its inhabitants, in which rational decisions are impossible and all meaning is meaningless and futile. Absurdity also describes many situations and events that take place in plays associated with the movement, such as orators who speak in gibberish, a clock that strikes 17, or a rhinoceros that walks across the stage. Cruelty and violence. Beneath the non-violence and slapstick humor of absurdism, lurk an element of cruelty, often revealed in dialogue between characters, but occasionally manifested in acts of violence also. Next is domination. Several well-known absurdist work feature pair of characters in which one is dominator and the other is dominated. Next is futility and passivity. The futility of all human endeavor characterized many absurd work, such as Edmond's Ping Pong, in which two promising students abandon their studies and devote their lives to the appreciation of pinball machines. Beckett's Waiting for Godot suggests that human effort is meaningless and leads to nothing in the end. Beckett's characters are so ineffective and doomed to failure that they are unable even to commit suicide successfully despite two attempts. Their passivity, established by their intermingled waiting, is even more famously illustrated by the closing scenes of both first and second acts. Next is language. The failure of language to convey meaning is an important theme in the literature of absurdism. Language is either detached from any interpretation that can be agreed by all characters, or it is reduced to complete gibberish. Next is loneliness and isolation. Many absurd works illustrate the loneliness and isolation of individuals. resulting from the nature of modern life and in some cases from the impossibility of effective communication between humans. Next theme is materialism. Materialism is criticized in Edward Albee's The American Dream, in which even relationships between family member are subject to the terms of profit and loss statement. Woman marries a man she doesn't love simply because he is wealthy and they buy a baby to complete their family. The baby dies, leaving them to mourn their financial loss rather than their emotional loss. Next is dialogue. Since the ability of language to convey meaning is called into question by absurdism, dialogue is of special importance in absurdist works. Artificial language, empty of meaning, consistency of slogans and cliches is a hallmark of the absurdist movement. Next is plot. Absurdism at its most extreme abandons conventional notion of plot almost entirely. Beckett's Waiting for Godot has been described as a play in which nothing happens. Its opening line is nothing to be done, and the characters proceed to do just that, nothing. Next is setting. The use of setting is one of the most unconventional stylistic feature of absurdism. Typically, an absurdist play is set in no recognizable time or place. Stage setting tends to be sparse, with lots of vacant space, conveying the sense of emptiness associated with the characters' lives. Now, we see some most famous representative dramatist of absurdist, Samuel Beckett, whose Waiting for Godot is the most important play. Harold Pinter's The Birthday Party, Eugene Ionesco's Rhinoceros is famous play. Tom Stoppard's Waiting, Jean Genet, Fernando Arevalo, Arthur Edmore, and Edward Albee, whose The American Dream is most famous play. So, thank you. I hope you have got the idea of the theater of absurd. Thank you.